Well, we got everything laid out in our new kitchen project, so now it's time to move forward and get some shop drawings going. In the next video, we're going to start off with our 2D plan drawings, and then we'll move on to some other videos where we'll cover our elevation and cross sections. So if you're ready, let's start this next lesson in Toolbox. All right, so let's go ahead and get the new kitchen project opened up again. We've spent the time on updating all the cabinets, making sure that they're drawn correctly, along with the different component inserts and subassemblies inside of those products. So since we've already got all that updated and everything's good to go, or at least good enough to start putting together some shop drawings, that's going to be the next phase in this project. So there are a couple steps when we go through this process. You can see already I have a couple lines drawn just to give myself some reference points. Start with our plan view and have it aligned with these walls here, and then we'll use this reference point to add an elevation drawing. Now I've already gone through our project settings and updated our global variables. See here, product description turned off. Finish labels have been updated to look to a wizard variable instead of our cut parts component. We also went through our project wizard to do that under render finishing options. Now, if you haven't already seen one of our previous videos where we introduced the 2D drawing tools, I suggest you watch that. Otherwise, we'll continue moving on and get some drawings going so we can submit this to our customer and hopefully get approved so we can move into production. We'll start off by drawing the plan view of these walls. Going in the order again of how you want these walls to be drawn in 2D. Now you'll notice this pop-up window, please select walls that are all connected. Now I did that intentionally so you could see what happens when we have select entire product turned on. Because this wall had an obstruction, we had that column. So we just want to make sure that we have select entire product turned off before we start drawing our plan view. So there's also a few things here that I've left on, so we can go over those together. I don't really want to see all these dimensions, at least maybe not in the location where they currently are. So let's just go through really quickly to update our walls and turn off some of those dimension tokens, as they're called. Now into some of the products, you can see here that we have our finished end turned on. So because of that, it's giving us our right end dimension and our right finished end text. Same thing with this upper. If we don't want to show that dimension, we can just go into our 2D drawing options under the prompts page. We have a couple dimensions that are coming in from the product. So we would have to go through our 2D drawing tokens if we don't want those to be shown. And just to go under the hood really quick, we'll take a look to see where those are at. Our 2D instructions subassembly. Notice under the prompts page, we have our plan view instructions, and that draw dim token is a formula driven token that's looking to a local prompt whether or not it should turn on or not. So we're going to spend a little more time on drawing tokens in another video. For now, we're just going to leave that on and move on to dimensioning the rest of this plan view. Now, the way that I'm going to dimension this, I don't want to have my upper dimension outside of the countertop depth. So we can go into our prompts to see if there's something in here where we can change that. Text location is only for the elevation. So this is a global variable that we'd have to go into to make the change under our shop drawings, 2D plan drawings, and we would have our depth offset dimension here. Currently it's at 24. We can change that. Again, this is just a conversion formula. So since I'm not working in a metric library, I can just update that to 12, hit okay, and now redraw that back in our drawing. And now I can just move this slightly outside of that, and that looks a lot better. Add a dimension here for window, our dim continue command. I still got a little too much clutter going on here, so I'm just gonna clean up a few more dimensions. Now, one other thing that I don't wanna have in my plan view is this finished end text showing up. But if I went into the prompts again and we were to turn that off, it's gonna also turn off on the elevation. So we're going to go about hiding that a different way. Currently, it is on a 2D dim layer. What we can do is hide the layer that it's on, but because it's 2D dim, that's not the layer that we want to hide. Now, the reason it's coming in on that layer is because that's how my current layer was set when those cabinets were first drawn in. So changing it again to 0, we can go back through and just redraw the cabinets that have a finished end. Now, you notice nothing highlighted there, but as we go over and cross to see our 3D objects, they've been highlighted, so we can be sure they're gonna redraw. And now that we have those three cabinets redrawn, you'll notice that our finished end text layer now set to 0. So it gives us an option or another way that we can not have it show up on our plan view. After everything looks good in model space, the next step will be going into our sheets and fitting that inside of one of our viewports. Be sure to check out our next couple videos that'll go through that process. That concludes another Microvellum University training session. Thanks again, and I'll meet you back here for the next one.